someone to stand with them, we can hire them for $5 each.
There you go.
The deal is, though, you have to take them home with you. So, so then after we go to Cana and renew our wedding vows and see the place where actually the original ruins of the city underneath, then we will go to Nazareth and have lunch. We have our own restaurant reserved. Most everywhere we go for lunch, we have the whole restaurant to ourselves. And then we'll have some grilled meats and salads and things. We'll explain that when we get there. And then we will go to Nazareth, which is where everything began, if you think about it. If it weren't for Nazareth, there would be no Bethlehem. Without Nazareth, there'd be no Jerusalem. We wouldn't be visiting these places. It all began in Nazareth, where the Word became flesh. In fact, on the altar there, it says, the Word became flesh here. That's great. Discussing with him, they knew about the current events and what was going to happen in the future, and they were discussing it with Jesus. What does that tell us about those who die and go to be with the Lord prior to us, those saints who are there? They're aware of what's going on. They're with God in heaven, and they very much understand what's going on with us. So that's one point. The second point is, Peter said, let us build a booth here. This is a great thing. Let us build a booth, for one for Elijah, one for Moses, and one for you. And Peter said, what's this thing about building a tent up here? Well, it was during the Feast of Tabernacles for the Jews. The Jews had come out of the land of Egypt, and God says, in order so that you never forget that, all through your generations, during the Festival of Booths, once a year, you will move out of your house, you will build temporary dwellings covered with branches, and you will live in those booths. Temporary houses. Jesus and his disciples were up here during the Feast of Booths, and what Peter was saying is, why don't we build those booths like we're supposed to, and we'll live up here in those booths? It was actually a very bright thing to say, not a dumb thing to say. But Jesus, he's transcending all of that, and he said, you know, pretty soon the cloud left and it was all over, and they said all they saw was Jesus alone. That's the main point of that. Moses represented the law. Elijah represented the prophets. It represents the whole Old Testament. The law and the prophets are represented there. And when they're gone, what do you see? Jesus alone. He supersedes the old covenant. He stands alone. Now let's go through really quickly what happens there. Jesus comes up. He's transfigured. His face turns bright. It says that his clothes are whiter than any launderer on earth can make them. His face is shining brightly. A cloud comes down. A voice from heaven says, this is my son. Listen to him. And it's on a mountain. When you have something that happens on a mountain, what should you ask yourself? Is there another mountain that I should look at to better understand what happens on this mountain? This is how the Bible works. If it's on a mountain, something happens, you say, what other mountain might I look to? What mountain do you think you would look to? Mount Sinai, yes. Because what happened on Mount Sinai? Moses went up Mount Sinai, and when he came down, what happened to his face? It says that his face was so bright and glowing that nobody could look him in the face. They had to put a veil over Moses' face, or you couldn't even look at him. What happens to Jesus here? Jesus is the new Moses. All the time in the Gospels, you'll see it over and over again on this trip. Jesus is the new Moses.
So I ask you to repeat what I say. I renew and reaffirm. My wedding vows to you. Once again, I promise to love and honor you.
Once again, I promise to love and honor you.
In good times and in bad.
In
sickness and in health.
For better or for worse.
All the days of my life. The love which these married couples have for one another. The wedding rings they once exchanged are the sign of their fidelity. May they continue to prosper in the grace of the sacrament.
Everybody's having lunch at St. George's Restaurant, Christian restaurant here in Nazareth. And the food, oh, sorry, food is flying. Very nice place.
Back at the beautiful Round Beach Hotel. We had a great day. We went to the Basilica of the Annunciation and we spent the day here along the Sea of Galilee in Nazareth. Join us. It's a great trip.
Thank you, Teresa, Tamio. Now, Janet, what did you think?
Oh my goodness. My first time here, climbing up the top of Mount Tabor, looking down. It was absolutely amazing.
Good.
And then getting to pray inside the side chapel, Elijah's Chapel, and putting my rosaries there. And I'm just really, it's absolutely amazing, this whole trip.